is my white man dance. I'm one step away from Big Fish, Little Fish cardboard box. What's up, guys, and welcome. We're back at Black Country Barbell, and today we're going to be trying to add inches to our biceps. We are going to be rocking with some occlusion training. I have not done this before, but this is a training method where you wrap a specific little bandy band around a limb, and what the idea is to trap blood within the muscle and force it to be almost to pool the blood in the muscle while you work. And what this does is it allows you to create a hell of a lot of tension with very light weights. So this is actually a legitimate training method for you to be able to optimize your training when you're maybe suffering from an injury or can't lift heavy, getting aches and pains, or maybe you just want to try something a little bit different. So we're going to give it a go today, and we're going to literally measure my arm before, we're going to measure my arm afterwards, and we're going to see how many inches we can add to a single body part in just 10 minutes. That was less dramatic than
it was, wasn't it?
We're going to measure on a flex. Let's do flaccid to flex. There's an advertisement you'll never hear anywhere.
Oh boy.
Let's get out the swans. Right, this actually be interesting because a lot of you always ask me how big my arms are. I have no idea. But I tell you one thing, they're smaller than you think because I have tiny, tiny little joints, which gives the proportional, like the way they look in proportion to the joints makes them look way bigger than they actually are. So this will be interesting. So this is unflexed.
Yep. So you've got bang on 40 centimetres.
What's that in inches?
Just less than 16.
Ooh, that's not too shabby.
Not bad. No.
That's not bad, is it?
Bad.
Okay. Hang on.
That is all imperative.
How flexy do I get? Do I flex too? Peaky beaky. Get on the peak then, Jay. That's not on the peak. Come on, peak me up, man.
Wait. There we go. So we've got 16 and a half.
Is that the only changes?
Yeah.
Is that normal? Half an inch on a flex, not even worth flexing. All these years I've been wasting my time for that half an inch.
So
there's a definite joke in it, right? Moving on. Do a visual of before and after as well. So, here we go. Okay, so we have side, unflexed, side flexed. Then you've got the classic Lex pose, which is this. And that's not even flexed, that's relaxed. So if you ever want to know how to take a good side profile photo, it's relax the arm, chill, think about pizzas. Flexed. Oh, here we go, yes, a good one. Yeah, boosh to stoosh. Oh, people always ask about how, like, this gap here. This is just genetic. This is, like, where your insertion points are. You cannot change that. So people often ask, like, how do I get my peak up here? That's genetics. And the peak part of it, obviously we have a split in the bicep, which hopefully you'll see when we get crazily pumped, is working the inner and outer heads of the bicep whenever you're training. Just little added notes there. But anyway, hope that gives you a little... Yeah? Is that yep. One there as well? There we go.
Can we get a leg shot as well, mate? Leg poses, anything else?
Just pants off.
No, sorry.
Always trying to get my pants off. I can give you a sneaky calf.
Do you want yeah, why not? Yeah, go on.
Chicken ball sack.
It's bigger than his bunions.
Isn't it gnarly? Oh, yeah, you didn't see them, did you? Yeah. Popping out at you. The worst! The idea is, you have this basically on like a clipped lasso loop essentially. You tighten, lock it in, and the idea is we're letting blood flow into the muscle, but not back out. And then we're gonna be doing a rep scheme of
30, 15, 15, 15.
And we're supersetting bicep, tricep.
Yep, pick one movement, so we're gonna do cable curl, tricep push down. 30 reps on one, 30 reps on the other, 15, 15, 15, 15. Yes.
And the 30 on the first has to be unbroken. So that means we're picking super light weights. And you do still have to focus on the contraction. So it's just like you would anyway. You need that mind to muscle, you need that mechanism, everything locked in, everything dialed in. So this is gonna be incredibly light compared to normal. And this is where the joint sparing side of things comes in. And also being able to maybe hold your posture a little bit better, or maybe you've got some shoulder issues and things like that that are destabilizing. Anything where you need to maybe lighten the load but still want to get that work rate, this is where this is going to come into play. But you only do this for one exercise, right?
We're going to do two cluster sets.
Two cluster sets.
So it's going to be a giant cluster of bicep triceps, 3 minutes of rest where you take them off.
Okay.
And then we're going to do once more.
So two sets.
Two sets in total.
10 minutes.
Yep.
Whereabouts are we putting it?
As high up as you can. So literally right underneath your armpit. And you want it to be an 8 out of 10 in terms of tightness. You want it to be quite tight. You'll feel like a fluid shift as well.
Just so people feel better about it. Look, stretch marks. I'd just like to add that in there as well. Everybody has them, motherfuckers. There's a whole video on those if you want to go and watch them. It's called stretch mark removal, and it goes through everything you need to know about stretch marks, how to make them look better, how to deal with them. Number one, how to not really worry about them, because we all have them. Yeah, a little nice lad on there for you. Check it out on the channel. Okay, so that doesn't feel horrendously tight.
You want it to be about an 8 out of 10 tightness.
I don't know what a 10 out of 10 is, Jay.
10 out of 10 means you're fucking savagely hurting.
That feels like I have something on my... When I do tricep, that hurts a little bit.
Yeah.
Is that normal? On a massive bonus, I do now look like the ultimate warrior. The power of the ultimate warrior. Don't like the Ultimate Warrior, Jay.
Cool Man's version.
That's made me a little bit sad inside. I'm genuinely a bit nervous about this. Okay, and so 30 reps.
Yep.
Here we go. It is quite uncomfortable. Just generally, like that tricep flexing against it. I'm getting 30, no problem. Yeah. But I can already feel it.
Do you want to tell
it.
You when the worst one is?
No.
Second set of 15. Six,
7, 8, 9.
Oh,
that's stuck. 30. Whoa!
Okay. It's
starting to hurt now. Oh, that's not nice. Ooh. Oh. So there is the downside of the discomfort of this. Although saying that, 9, 10. I've bought ones with nice little padding inside.
Oh. Oh.
Oh, 36. 30 reps sucks anyway. This sucks even worse. Oh.
Perfect. Stay with it.
Fuck you.
Ah.
Fuck me. 2. All right, just kicked in. Okay, 6. Oh, that's... It's even hurting biceps whilst on triceps now.
Yeah, it does.
10. 3, 2. Oh, is this the last one?
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4. 3. Come on, fucker. 2. Oh, that's fucking... Come on. 9, 10, 5. That's all it is. 5. That's all it is. 5, 4, 3, 2. Tell me we can take the fuckers off. Oh, mother.
Cool. 3 minutes.
Oh, it's like someone's giving me 2 dead arms. So it feels like...
See the colour difference?
Yeah.
The colour difference.
That's, look at this, look how purple it's gone.
So Joe and I were having a discussion as to whether we should tell you how painful it's going
to
be.
I mean, you can get through it, don't get me wrong, but it's very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Very uncomfortable. That's and the pain is weird. It's like, you're like, okay, it's like a pump pain that you're fighting through, and then all of a sudden, it's like your skin just wants, just all of a sudden just starts to go, skin splitting pump is what it feels like, mainly on the biceps. The triceps is more of a general uncomfortable, but I think that's generally because we have peak on the biceps, so you do really feel that tension across the skin on that.
And like you said, even on your triceps, just because you're not even putting any load through it, but you're still moving it, you're saying even on triceps, it's still hurting your biceps when you're doing it.
Yes,
it
was.
If you were to pick like one exercise, if you can do this like just biceps, rather than doing supersets, you'd just do 30, 15, 15, 15, and just have 30 seconds in between each, so you're doing that same.
Let's go. A little bit more. Riddle more.
Yeah.
Channel.
Thirty.
Yep. 25. Five more legs, come on. 5, 4, 3, 2. Okay, that's more savage. Immediately more savage. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Come on. 3, 2. Oh! Ah! Ah! Oh my god! 10. Even though I'm horribly discomfort here, one thing I would say is I've got a bone bruise on my elbow at the moment, and that hurts on every tricep movement, but this is not hurting it at all. Ugh, which is.
Come on,
come on.
Let's go. What's this?
Last one. 10. Fuck you, 5 more. Come on.
Let's go.
Squeeze. Five, make them bleed. 4, bleed. 3, bleed. 2, no pain. Ah! 7, come on. 2, 3, 4, 5, oh my god. Ah. Jesus. Okay.
Let's get it. Let's see where we're at.
So apparently bang on 17 inches.
What was it, 16 before?
It was just less than 16 before.
Ooh. No doubt we're probably measuring it wrong and there's going to be an instant
of course.
Influx of,
of course.
You're doing it wrong, bro. Hey, it's only for fun.
Fuck.
I was trying to be diplomatic.
Awesome.
Fuck them. Okay, and then, so you want to be here on the head of the tricep there. So the tricep head is there, that's the peak head of the tricep.
Yeah, we also have the
then
peak.
It should line up.
Yes, this is. Boom.
What is it?
17 and a half.
We've added.
Well, 17 and three quarters it was.
Ooh, is that over an inch?
Yeah.
There you go, there we go. Difference, difference. Let's do the difference view. So what did we have? We had standard side.
Yeah.
The Lex Flex. Pizza. Oh, I can fucking feel that. Oh, that's insane. Does it look swollen though?
You see the visual difference.
Swollen big. And then I can't see it, there's no mirrors to enjoy this. But there we go. I think we've shown in 10 minutes we've added just over an inch. Just over an inch to the bicep. And you can see the pump. I mean, you can visually see it. It's way fuller here on that pop. It's hard. Now it's hard to even hit that contraction. And that's after just 2 sets of cluster sets. 30, 15, 15, 15. And it's there, bam. That hurts. It's so swollen still. So there we go. That is one impressive way for you to add inches to your arms in 10 minutes. So the reality of this is, it is a legitimate way to train, to be able to use lightweight, but still create maximum growth effect and get maximum potential from your workouts. It's gonna be joint sparing, which is something I'm always preaching against. You cannot smash heavyweight all the time, because eventually, you might be good now, it might not happen this week, next week, but over the time, you're grinding, something will pop and something will go. But the reality of it is, the more feathers to your bow or more arrows in your quiver, whatever the goddamn saying is, be versatile. Spread your knowledge throughout different realms. Don't get stuck. Don't be blinkered on just one way. There is many, many ways to do things wrong, just as there's many, many ways to do things very, very right. This has been occlusion training. So remember, it's one body part, one exercise. You're going to be doing 2 sets, cluster sets. So a 30 rep followed by 3 sets of 15s. It's basically supersets, one after the other, 2 times. And I promise you, you're gonna be in a different kind of discomfort, but you can get maximum
inches. The thing is that an inch and a quarter is quite impressive in other areas. Like, would these work, you know, just a bit?
Lately I've I've been doing shit different. Cooking like a chef, I've been all up in the kitchen. Had to make a move, had to make a little distance. A lot of people tripping, they could never see the vision. Fuck that.